person who registers for the Qlik Cloud subscription is a service account owner and tenant admin. As a tenant admin, you have access to the management console where you configure and manage the Qlik Cloud Analytics Standard tenant for your organization. The Home section gives you an overview of the consumption of user allocation, reloads, and other capacity-based resources. It also shows a list of the capabilities that are enabled with your subscription and the limits on those capabilities. In the Users pane, you can invite new users by email and activate or disable existing ones. When you invite a user to the tenant by email, they sign in with their Qlik ID, but you can also set up other identity providers. Once the user you've invited logs in, the user is automatically assigned the full user entitlement. Tenant administrators manage user access rights by assigning roles. User roles enable actions on resources, such as editing apps or opening data files. By assigning roles to users, you can better organize your users and what they can do in the tenant. On the Permissions tab, you see all available security roles. You can assign security roles to all users in the tenant from the auto-assign column, or you can turn off the auto-assign roles. You can select a role to see all users assigned to this role. From here, you can assign roles to users or groups. Groups are defined through your identity provider and not created from the management console. By default, authentication is completed by Qlik using your Qlik ID, but you can set up other identity providers. In the Identity Provider section, you can manage the identity providers used in the tenant. There are several types of identity providers to choose from. As a tenant administrator, you can also create and maintain shared or data spaces. Shared spaces are used by a defined group of users to develop apps. Apps inside a shared space are only accessible by the group of users who have access to the space. Data spaces are governed areas of your Qlik Cloud tenant that are used to create and store data projects in Qlik Cloud data integration. Selecting a space, you can edit the space or change the space owner. You can add space members by clicking the Manage Members button. When you add members to a space, you can assign space roles to them. Each space role is a set of permissions that define what members can do in the space. As a tenant admin, you can manage all alerts created in the tenant and enable or disable them. In the Subscription section, you can enable or disable individual subscriptions, delete a subscription, or change the owner of a subscription. In the Schedule section, you can view and delete reload schedules of the app. In the Events section, you can follow up on events in your system and get information about the event type and the user who initiated the event. On the Apps section, you can move apps between personal spaces and shared spaces. You can also change the owner of apps and delete them. In the Data Connections section, you can manage data connections. A tenant admin, analytics admin, or data admin can move a data connection from any of the space types to which they have access to their personal space. In the Generic Link section, you can make external resources available in the cloud. You might have apps in a deployment of QlikSense Enterprise on Windows, or useful QlikSense mashups that are relevant to members of specific spaces. You can either create a single link or upload a CSV file containing the generic links. In the Extensions section, you can add and manage third-party extensions. In the Theme section, you can upload your custom themes. In the API Keys section, the tenant admin manages system integration through API keys and web integrations. By default, API keys are disabled. To enable them, go to the Settings section. You can use API keys to authenticate users, developers, or other programs. The Content Security Policy section helps to detect and mitigate certain types of attacks, including cross-site scripting and data injection attacks. In the OAuth section, tenant admins can administer OAuth clients. In the Web section, you can create and manage web integrations. Web integrations let you create an allow list of domains that can access the tenant. When a web integrated domain requests a connection with the tenant, for example, an embedded visualization, Qlik Cloud checks the allow list of approved domains. A webhook is an HTTP callback that passes system event information about events in Qlik Cloud tenants to other applications. The application that receives the outbound webhook information can use it to trigger other tasks in the workflow. The Settings section is where you can view your tenant information and enable or disable many of the features and functionalities in Qlik Cloud. Here, you can configure a tenant alias, enable or disable on-demand data, enable or disable specific features, enable and disable API keys, configure an email server, enable or disable chart sharing and subscriptions, enable offline usage for mobile, and set an expiration value for token expiration. Data Gateway provides a secure means of accessing or moving firewalled data for use in Qlik Cloud. There are two types of gateways, one for analytics services known as Qlik Data Gateway Direct Access, and the other for data integration services, known as Qlik Data Gateway Data Movement. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.